everybody, welcome back to the Waiver Wave. I'm your host, Tim Petropoulos, and I am back after missing last week. It's good to be back, guys. How you been? How's the family? As you guys can probably tell, I'm a little under the weather this week. But, just like life, I have to move forward. And I'm not just gonna let one little thing get in the way. And that's the theme of today's Waiver Wave. Guys that you've forgotten about and have become fantasy irrelevant, now, all of a sudden, it is their time and it is your time to take advantage. My number one waiver priority this week is Redskins running back Samaje Perine. 2 weeks ago, Perine was lost in the oblivion of fantasy nothingness. Rob Kelly was the first and second down back, and Chris Thompson was getting all the passes. Let's get a moment of silence for Chris Thompson, the first person ever on the waiver wave. Now he's the only back in a potent offense, and he had his breakout game right on time. Perine went for 126 total yards on 23 carries and one catch. That is a big game for a rookie that's going to need to break out of his shell now more than ever. You could put Perine in your running back two spot and be confident as long as the other backs stay hurt. My number two waiver priority this week is Corey Coleman, wide receiver for the Browns. Now, the Jaguars' pass defense has been well documented. They've given up the least amount of fantasy points to wide receivers in the league this year, by far, and they have the best cornerback combo in the league, with Jalen Ramsey shutting down most people. Despite that, Corey Coleman still put up 6 catches, still put up 80 yards, and this is his first game back after missing since week 2, and he has a rookie as his quarterback. In case you forgot, Corey Coleman is a baller. Put this dude on your roster, thank me later. My number three waiver priority is another running back, and it's Devontae Booker. Now, this guy's not as much as a sure thing as Perine. If you're getting Perine, you're putting him right in. For Booker, it's a little bit more of a futures play. Right now, there is turmoil in Denver. CJ Anderson fumbled in a big spot yet again. On top of that, they just fired their offensive coordinator, and Devontae Booker out-touched and out-snapped CJ Anderson for the first time all year this week. If you're the Broncos and you're out of contention, who are you going to roll with? CJ Anderson, a guy who you know what he brings? Or are you going to give the young guy a shot? I think that Booker could take a stronghold on this backfield. Now, that's not to say he's going to be successful when he does, but opportunity is the king of fantasy. Take a chance, pick up Devontae Booker. Another guy that you should own is Kenny Stills, but there's a catch. Kenny Stills just went for 180 yards. That is a monster game. But there was a big difference between the first half and the second half, and that difference is Matt Moore was the quarterback. Going back to last season, of the last 5 touchdown passes that Matt Moore has thrown, 4 of them have been thrown to Kenny Stills. On top of that, 154 of his 180 yards last week came with Matt Moore under center. When Matt Moore is the quarterback, Kenny Stills has fantasy value. As long as Matt Moore is under center, go pick up Kenny Stills, put him in your wide receiver 3, and ride that wave, baby. My Wednesday Warriors this week is a name that you may not have heard before, but may ring some bells. Have you ever heard the name Aaron Rodgers? Aaron Rodgers is on the way back, and some reports have him coming back by week 15. If you're a person streaming quarterbacks, or a person who just has a quarterback on their fantasy roster in general, you must have Aaron Rodgers on your squad right now. Can you imagine having Aaron Rodgers for the semifinals and championship? Just imagine that. Take a second. Think about it. And finally, my pro tip of the week is start looking at playoff matchups. There's 3 different scenarios that people are in right now. They're either fighting for a playoff spot, really, really not fighting for a playoff spot, or they're in a position in the top 3 or 4 where they know a playoff spot is given to them. It's time to start thinking ahead for the playoffs, especially if you are streaming quarterbacks and tight ends. If you're used to going week to week and picking the best matchup, it's time now to start picking up matchups for the playoffs. Having these guys on the bench not only guarantees you a good matchup during playoff time, it guarantees you that the guy that you're playing is not getting that good matchup. Anyway, that's all for the Waiver Wave. You can catch me and my brothers doing this in depth every single week. We have every single matchup, every single player, every single game, everything you need to get ready for fantasy this weekend. So check out Broto Fantasy. And with that, I give you the wave. You just gotta ride it.